الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الذي جعل العفو والصفح من أخلاق الجميلة الذي جعل العفو والصفح من الأخلاق الجميلة والصفات الحميدة التي أمر الله بها نبيه وعباده المؤمنين وزينهم بها والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد الأمين أسوة المتقين من زكاه الله بالخلق العظيم وأكمل به الدين صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن اقتفى أثرهم إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله عز وجل All praises and thanks are due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى الذي جعل العفو the one that who made forgiveness was safha and to forget min al akhlaq al jamila among the beautiful manners was sifat al hamida and good characters التي أمر الله بها, the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded it, his messenger and the Muslims as a whole. وَزَيَّنَهُمْ بِهَا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautify forgiveness and for forget with his messengers and his slaves. والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد الأمين. Mercy and peace be upon his trustworthy messenger محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أسوة المتقين, the role model of the believers, the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recommended with a good manners. أَيْزَكَّاهُ اللَّهُ بِالْخُلُقِ الْعَظِيمِ وَأَكْمَلَ بِهِ الدِّينِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complete the deen by sending him as the last messenger of the universe. صَلَوَاتُ رَبِّي, my Lord's mercy, وَسَلَامُهُ عَلَيْهِ, and his peace be upon the noble Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his household and his followers and all of them, ajma'in, and those who follow his footsteps until the day of resurrection. Mawdu'una al-yawma ibadallah, our topic today is about forgiveness and forget, or in other words, forgiveness and turn away from the ignorant. وهو ما يسمى في اللغة العربية فضائل العفو والصفح عن الناس والصبر على آذاهم ظاهرا وباطنا, which means the virtues of forgiveness and forget upon the people, and to be patient with their disturbance or harmful actions in and out. As we said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the messenger and the believers to forgive and forget. And these is the hobbies of the messengers, is the hobbies of the pious people, and is the hobbies of the Muslims who are devoted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is our justification? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, admonishing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Surah Al-A'raf 199. Allah say, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. You forget Surah Al-A'raf verse 199. Allah say, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, take to forgiveness and enjoy good and turn aside from the ignorant, which means وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, ignore them, turn away from them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran verse 159, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضَّلْ غَلِيدَ الْقَلْبِ لَمْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَعْفُ عَنْهُمْ. I stop there because I got what I want, which is the justification only I need. What this means? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, And had you been rough, faddal, rough. Walid al-qalb, hard-hearted. What's going to be? If their messenger is rough, if the messenger has been hard-hearted, is he going to bring people together? If you become rough yourself, you become hard-hearted, would you able to bring the community or your relatives or your household together? Well, jawab, if you are rough or hard-hearted, what would have happened? Allah say, لَمْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ, they would certainly have run away from you. But what you should do? If somebody do something that you don't like, or somebody harm you, or somebody says something about you, you're not happy, what you should do? Allah say, فَعْفُ عَنْهُمْ, forgive them. Forgive them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah An-Nur, verse 22. This ayah, we're going to see the tafsir of this scholars. The ayah says, وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولِي الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. What this mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and those of you who process grace and abundance, let not swear against giving to the nearest or to the near of kin, and poor, and those who strive for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah say, don't you love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should forgive you? And Allah is forgiven and He is merciful. This ayah, it has a sabab al-nuzul. The cause for it to be revealed, it has it, inshallah, we're going to dealt with it after this. Ma huwa al-afu? What is forgiveness? Or in other words, what is the differences between forgiveness and forget or turn away? Al-afu huwa kaffu ad-darari ma'a al-qudrati alayhi. Kullu man istahaqqa 'uqubatan wa tarakaha fa hadha at-tarku yusamma 'afwan. What this mean? Al-afu, to forgive, huwa kaffu ad-darar, is to stop retaliating ma'al-qudrati alayhi, why you are capable and you are able to retaliate. But you say, okay, you do something to me, I have the ability to do it, but I'm not going to do it. This is what we call afu. You're able to retaliate, but you say, you know what, I will leave it for the sake of Allah. How many people do that? If I do something to you today, if I do 1,000 goods to you today, if I do one evil to you, you forget about all the 1,000 deeds. That's a human being. So the difference is, this as-safh wal-afu, they are so close. But illa anna safha ablagh min al-afu. But the word forget or turn away is more eloquent than to forgive. Why? لأن الإنسان قد يعفو ولا يصفح. Because sometimes you can forgive me what I have done, but you will never forget it. You will never. until you forget it, it means still there. That's why Allah say, وَلْيَعْفُ, let them forget, let them forgive, وَلْيَسْفَهُ, and let them forget about it. How many people? You can even remember what somebody has done to you since 40 years ago, 50 years ago. You don't forget it. Why? And Allah is telling us to forget about it. So let us open a new page. It is something very, very difficult. Let's get some examples about forgiveness. As I said, the first verse that the walayat al udil fadli minkum, Ibn Kathir says, wal ya'fu wal yasfahu, let them forget and forgive. And this ayah was revealed upon Abu Bakr al Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and may Allah has mercy upon him. When? Why? Why this ayah was revealed? Matter. Hina halafa, when Sayyidina Abu Bakr swear that he is not going to help his cousin anymore. Al-Musamma Mistah ibn Abi Athatha. Mistah, it was his auntie's son, the relative from the mom's side. But why? Why did he say, I'm not going to do it? Because Mistah did something. In other words, he interfered in the hadithatul ifk, the false accusation of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. You know, people try to accuse her of doing something that he never did in her life. That is why even the wives of the Prophet are not saved from the people's tongue or mouth. You are not going to be saved. So when he join these people to say these things, then Abu Bakr say, you know what, I'm going to stop helping you. I'm not going to help you anymore. Because I could not believe you would join these munafiqun, these people, to talk about my own daughter in this way. But what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? And he revealed the previous verse that you, those who have grace and abundance, should not sway against giving or helping the near of kin. You should. Then what happened? Anzalallahu bara'ata Aisha radiallahu anha, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a verse that Aisha was, she was innocent. People are just trying to make things up. Then after that, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anha, what he did? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُرُ رَحِيمٌ. Don't you want, or don't you love, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you your sins? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiven and most merciful. When the ayah was revealed, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anha, he replied, Bala, yes. Wallahi, I swear by Allah, Inni uhibbu an yaghfira Allahu li. I love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. What did he do after that? ثم رجع إلى مستح ما كان يسيله من النفقة وقال أبو بكر والله لا أنزعها منه أبدا. And after that Abu Bakr said, I love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive my sin, and he started being kind or helping Mistah as he used to be before the hadithatul ifk, before the false accusation, and he go back and started helping him as he used to. And he said this, Wallah, I swear by Allah, la anzi'uha minhu abada, I will never stop helping this young man forever. I will still maintain to help him until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes me away. Example number two, forgiveness, forget. عليه وسلم لزعماء قريش الذين أذوه وقتلوا أصحابه وأخرجوه من بلده مكة. قال اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء. وهذا دليل على أن العفو من صفاته صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the word of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to the leaders of the Quraysh, those who killed his followers, those who kicked him out of Mecca, and those who disturbed him a lot. And when he got the upper hand, the power, what did he say to them? I'm going to retaliate. I'm going to wipe all of you on the surface of the planet. I'm going to do it now. Because they was expecting him to do so. But what did he say? Idhabu, go! Fa'antumutulaqa, you are free. I'm not going to do anything to you. You are free, go. Meaning, you have forgiven. Nothing is in my heart for you. You teach them a lesson. Number three, wal'afu min sifatil anbiya'i sabiqin. Forgiveness, it is a character of the prophets in the past. Do I have a justification? Yes. Allah Ta'ala and Yusuf alayhi salam wa huwa yukhatib ikhwati. Allah told us about Sayyidina Yusuf when he was talking to his brothers. We know what they did to him. Now don't kill him, just put him in a dark hole. Some people come and pick him up. When he has the upper hand, he becomes the finance minister of Egypt. Allah raised him up. What did he say? لا تثريب عليكم اليوم يغفر الله لكم وهو أرحم الراحمين. He said, Yusuf said, there shall be no reproof against you, my brothers. This day, اليوم. You see, عليكم upon you. Then the اليوم come after the word عليكم. Sometimes if you don't be careful this and you mix it, you say لا تثريب اليوم عليكم. We say لا تثريب عليكم. You see, اليوم, today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may forgive you. Allah is the most merciful, most forgiving. In other words, وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ, most merciful of the most merciful. This is Yusuf. He has forgiven his brothers. He has forget everything. Rabian. And the fourth example, we said it is the character of the pious. وَمِنْ مِثَالُ ذَلِكَ فَفِي أَهْدِ الْخَلِيفَةِ الْمُعْتَصِمِ. At the time of Khalifat al-Mu'tasim, سُجِّنَ إِمَامُ أَحْمَدُ رَحِيَمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal was imprisoned. وَضُرِبَ بِالصِّيَاطِ حَتَّى عُضُمِيَ عَلَيْهِ. He was beaten until he became fainted. وَسَالَ الدَّمُ مِنْ جَسَدِهِ. The blood was running out of his body. But what did he do? وَعَفَ عَنْ. And he forgave Mu'tasim. وَسُجِّنَ إِمَامُ مَالِكِ. Imam Malik was imprisoned too. وَضُرِبَ بِالصِّيَاطِ. And he was beaten with whips. حَتَّى إِنْ خَلَأَتْ يَدَهُ مِنْ كَتْفِ. Until this, his hand moved from his shoulder. It's Imam Malik. The great scholars of this deen. ماذا فعل? Did Imam Malik retaliate? لا. فَعَفَى أَمَّنْ دَرَبَهُ. And he was forgiven and forget those people who do these things to him. So it's just like I'm speaking to myself. You should forgive. Allah loves those who forgive others. We know it is very difficult. We can forgive, but to forget is another thing. And this, we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let Him give us the courage to forgive and forget. If you find yourself not able to forget things, put it in supplication. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you forgetting about all things that people have done to you in the past, so that you attain the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafurur rahim. I said what I have said. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. He is the most merciful, most forgiven. الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد فواعد العفو the benefits of forgiveness واحد امتثال أمر الله عز وجل following the commandment of Allah سبحانه وتعالى because Allah, He is the one that commands us to give and forget. To forgive and forget. ثانياً العجر العظيم من الله. And the great reward of to forgive and forget is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الرفعة في الدنيا والآخرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you forgive and forget and humble yourself, Allah will raise you this world and the year after. Do I have a justification? Yes. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, وما زاد الله عبدا بعفو إلا عزا وما توعد أحد لله إلا رفعه. رواه مسلم. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not increase a slave because of forgiveness and forget, illa izzan, except honor and respect. وَمَا تَوَادَ أَحَدٌ لِلَّهِ. Anyone that who humble himself for the sake of Allah, you are not humbling yourself for the dunya, you're humbling yourself for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, illa rafa'ahu Allah, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise him to the highest ranking. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among these people. Amen. Number six, nashr al-mahabbati wal-ikhwati bayna al-muslimin, spreading the love between Muslim sisters and brothers. And the other one, forgiveness and forget, annahu tariqun muwassilun ila al-jannah, it is the way that will pave for you to go to Jannah. Because if you forgive this type of people, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. So it's better to forgive before you leave it until down there, when they will take, or you will take from their good deeds, and if there is nothing else left for them, only evil, and they will take your evil and give to them, and that will cause them to go to hell. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the courage of forgiveness and forget. اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين والمسلمات اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم واسلم حالهم واغسلهم بالماء والسلام وبارك ونقيهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما انك غفور رحيم باذن الله نسيا ربنا الظالمين وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم في العالمين انك حميد مجيد. Sorry, a quick reminder. And brothers and sisters, as you can see, the masjid is in need of a fund of paying its bills. So please, brothers and sisters, help the masjid to fulfill this payment of its bills for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah put it in your reward yawm al-qiyamah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.